Here is why the movie quote is still playing. Thus far in Record Sounds View Controller, we have a function called Audio Recorder Did Finish Recording. And inside this function, what we are doing is saving the recorded audio. By the way, we are tracking two things about the audio, its file path and its title. Now, even though we are saving the recorded audio, we're not quite passing it from the first scene to the second. If we want to play the sounds in the second view controller, we need to pass this data to the second scene. Let's do that next. Now, to do this, I will go back to Record Sounds View Controller and introduce you to another function that we inherit from UI View Controller. It's called prepareForSegue. And as I start to type it, Xcode auto-completes it for me. This function, prepareForSegue, it gets called just before a segue is about to be performed and therefore is a great place to pass any data. In here, I will add an if statement and check to see if my segue identifier is stop recording. Now, this type of a check becomes really important when we have multiple segues connected to the same view controller. All right, to pass data to this second view controller, we somehow need a way to access it in code. And I can do that with this line. Here I created a constant called playSoundsVC and then defined its appropriate type and then used Segway's destination view controller property to get a handle on the second view controller in our app. I also used the as keyword in Swift to convert this destination view controller to the correct type we are expecting, which is playSoundsViewController. Okay, so now that we have a way to access playSoundsViewController in code, let's think about how we are going to pass data to it. We can get our data from this sender parameter. Remember that sender is the object that initiated the segue, which in our case was recorded audio. So I can write a line of code like this to retrieve the data. So now I just need to pass this data to playSoundsViewController. But wait, this guy, playSoundsViewController, it doesn't really have a way of receiving any data just yet, does it? So to fix this, what I will do is go to playSoundsViewController from the navigator and create a new variable called receivedAudio. Now this variable is of type recordedAudio. This was the new class we created. Now if you go back to prepareForSegue, I can pass the data in this manner. I can say playSoundsViewController.receivedAudio. This is the new variable we created in playSoundsViewController. This is now equal to data. Cool, let's run this project. All right, let me record something. Is the app working now? Let me play the sound.
My mom always said, life was like a box of chocolates.
The app is still playing a movie quote. Care to guess why that is happening? Enter your response in this box.